Hi again. So last lesson, we created a catenary system which works like a hanging chain, whereby we divided a line into different segments, and for each segment we applied a force, upwards or downwards, and then linked them together, and then played the system out to develop these types of curves, which are really useful in architecture as super efficient arches. Now what we want to do is, this is still a 2D system. Now we're going to take this into 3D. So let's get rid of most of this stuff. Remember, we're still working with our very basic three elements, which are going to be our vector forces on each point, which act as weight, our anchor points, the points which are not going to move in the simulation, and our line forces, which basically maintain a given length between different points, or they act as springs or a chain. This is a component that lets us interact with the model in real time by picking at points. It's not super useful, but it's quite fun, so it's good to leave in. So let's just disable this. Whenever you're making big changes to the model, it's good to disable the solver, just you don't want any awful surprises. So instead of just having one string, what we're going to do is we're going to create a mesh and extract lines from it, which are going to be in a grid. So let's get rid of these two points. And what we're going to do is we're going to create a plane which we're later going to mesh. So you can choose any size you want. So we're going to have a mesh and we're going to have four anchor points. I just drew a rectangle surface. And I'm going to select the corners, and those points are going to be my anchor points. So just to recap, we're going to have one point input for our anchor points, which is right here. We're going to have points inputs for these weight forces, and we're going to have line inputs for the line element. So that should be quite neat. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to put this surface into the definition. And the way that we turn this into a mesh is using the BREP to mesh tool. Now you can click the mesh edges component to check what the edges are being subdivided like. You can hide this at the moment. So this at the moment isn't showing any edges because we actually have to modify the way that this is meshing the surface in order to control how finely subdivided this is going to be. So the way that we do that is we click on the settings custom component, and you can already see that changed something. But by modifying the maximum and minimum edge values here, we can define what the subdivision is like. So I chose a subdivision of 1, but you can go for varying levels of detail. So basically, this is going to determine the resolution of the system. So that gives us a mesh. Now, for our line elements, we're going to want all of these segments extracted and put into this component. So that's quite easy to do with the mesh edges. So all you have to do is plug these into here. And so those are already set. And remember how this works. So this is telling each of these segments to try to be a given length. And what I did here was set a multiplier. So I can multiply how many times its starting length it wants to be. So at the moment, it's 1.5 times its starting length. So when I start this, these are going to want to get longer. Now, next part. We want to add weights to all of the vertices in this mesh. The way that you do that is going to mesh, deconstruct mesh, and that's going to give you all of the vertices in the mesh. So just take those, plug them into there. And finally, we want anchor points. And the anchor points that we want are these four points at the corners. Okay, so our system should be ready. So let's run this. This actually runs faster if you disable all of the outputs until it converges. So let's start this. Well, no, you have to, whenever you do, you make big changes and you see things going really wrong, you want to try to reset it by clicking true and then going ahead and running it. And so let's just hide all of the inputs so you can see just what's being changed. So here we go. So what's happening here? This is actually working in 2D still. So that's why this is working like a very weird 2D cloth trying to sort itself together. Why? Because the direction of the forces that we'd applied are still acting on the Y direction, when actually now we want them to act in the Z direction. So let's reset this. Just choose a Z vector. Swap them. And you can see this is slowly acting like a hanging net. Now, this is actually pretty slow at the moment. So what you want to do is you want to increase the number of iterations for this value. So it doesn't show every single step. It's showing you less steps. So let's just change that from 10 to 20. Let's run that again. And that should be a bit faster now. Now, you can change this in several ways. You can reduce the size of each of these members. And that's going to reduce the shape, as if it were a smaller net that's being made to hang. And this is still creating a catenary system, kind of Gaudi style. So this is just designed quite an effective structure. Now, what we can do is say we can play around with these in certain ways. You can change the points that are anchoring it. Or you can even add an extra point, for example. So you can start to decide what you want something, a system like this to do and plan. And then now you can insert all of these points again. Now, again, when you make big changes, you want to reset the system. Now see, it'll run, it'll say that it's running when it's still calculating, and eventually it will say converged. And that's when the solution has reached a stable point. So how do you actually get geometry out of here? What we had done before is we had seen that all of the geometry is output through here. But at the moment, all that's being output and processed are lines and points. So I can get lines out of here. And I can bake that. Oops, I was having a little bit of trouble selecting what I baked, but I can see what I did now. Because this is placed in rendered and it's not showing any of the curves. So, I might have actually baked this 10,000 times. So let's just bake it once. And let's just try to pipe this. And you can see that actually makes quite a cool, efficient structure. And you can design this in any size and just play around with where you want the supports to be. But now I've output lines, but what if I want to output the actual surface? At the moment, this system isn't taking into account the actual mesh and just the lines. The way to get around this is go back to the Kangaroo panel, and there's going to be a component called show right next to the solver. What this does is it lets you put in geometry that you want it to modify concurrently with the vertices and lines, in this case the mesh. So if you link the mesh to this component and then just insert this component here as well, then that's going to put the mesh into this list. So now all you have to do to just get the mesh out is just have a mesh component which just takes out every piece of geometry that's not a mesh. Bake that. And you've got this. Now, because we're using sort of a low resolution mesh at this point, you can see that it's not as smooth as it could be in certain areas. So if you want to have this ready for render, you might want to increase the resolution. Okay, so this is showing you how to take the simple catenary system into 3D. Now, in the next lesson, we're going to stick with, again, these same elements. We're going to stick with this same panel, but we're going to start to work with this as a membrane system, which is a pretty key difference. So stay tuned.